Look, show up, show up. Back out, pull up. Midtown, roll up. Midtown, roll up.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to SWN. S is breaking news coverage on the Protestant Reformation.
Today's coverage is sponsored by
Nino's Pizza, Route 130, North Brunswick, New Jersey. Watchong Pediatrics in Melbourne, Fanwood, and Warren. And BMI Janitorial in Scotch Plains, New Jersey.
The first topic of discussion is the Protestant Reformation.
Now, the cause of the Protestant Reformation was the movement against the Holy Roman Church, sparked by Luther because of the corruption, a religious movement of the 16th century that began as an attempt to reform the Roman Catholic Church and resulted in the creation of Protestant churches.
Did you know that some historians call the Protestant Reformation Protestant Revolution?
No, I did not. What is the reason for this?
So, the reason for this is because the Protestant Reformation was a religious reform movement that swept through Europe in the 1500s. It resulted in the creation of a branch of Christianity called Protestantism, a name used to refer to many religious groups that separated the Roman Catholic Church due to differences in the doctrine.
Ah, I heard of that indulgence. An individual could reduce the length and severity of punishment that heaven will require as a payment for their sins, or so the church claimed.
Yes, but only if they don't truly understand their faith.
Ah, I see. Wait. We're now receiving a video from St. John Paul II.
People should recognize the unity that already exists and to push for a time when God's church will once again bring all people who consider themselves Christian.
Well, there you have it, directly from St. Paul II himself.
And when we get back, we will find out more about Martin Luther and who he was and what he had intended to do. How's it going, guys? I'm here with
Martin Luther.
Thank you for joining us, Martin. How are you today?
Hey, Dan, I'm doing all right, but I just got excommunicated, so could be doing better.
So, Martin, first off, can you describe your childhood to us?
No, I received a typical education at the time, and my father was very strict, disciplinarian, and a friar. So at 14, I moved away from home because my dad wanted me to get the best education. And I prayed 8 times a day and devoted my life to being a monk and devoted my life to God.
What is scripulosity and how did it affect you?
It is defined as the quality of one whose conscience judges an action to be morally evil when it is not, or judges a sin as moral when it is not. It affected me because I think that God was stirred up by society on that day. This is one of the reasons I challenged the Catholic Church.
That's pretty interesting. I never knew that. How did you view God?
I view God as a stern judge, and no matter what penances I perform, I cannot get a sense of God's love and his offer of salvation. I think he is a harsh judge and dispenser of justice.
Now, tell me, what are some of your main objections to the Catholic Church?
I objected to the use of indulgences. I do not believe that the Catholic Church has the power to pardon people's sins.
What were some positive things that you believe describe you and your relation to the church, Mr. Luther?
I visited churches, and I actually had many indulgences, but not through payment. I had them through penance.
Awesome. Why were you not content with certain things in the Catholic Church?
I wasn't content with certain things in the Catholic Church because of struggles of my own spiritual soul. I have different feelings about redemption than most people, and I have different views on how the church forgives people for their sins.
The biggest question asked and wanted to be answered by the people is about your 95 thesis.
Alright, let's hear them.
What led you to post the 95 thesis, and what do they say?
So, I wrote and I nailed the 35 theses to the door of the church as a result of my dissatisfaction with the practice of indulgence. I denounced the Roman Catholic Church's excess and corruption in my thesis, particularly the papal practice of charging indulgences for the remission of sins. My trust in justification by faith promoted me to challenge the Catholic Church's indulgences.
Okay, now, can you please describe what happens afterwards? Like, what was the Pope's response, and how do you reply to that?
Oh, Pope didn't like that one. June 1520, Pope Leo X issued a papal bull threatening him with excommunication because Jude was ratsacking. So, publicly, I burnt the bull on December 10th, 1520. In Wittenberg, actually, is where, it's also where I stapled the 95 pieces to the door of the church. And I was ended up being excommunicated in January, only a month later, 1521.
Wow. Okay, thank you so much for your time, Mr. Luther. You're truly an inspiration to all of us here at the Catholic Church.
Of course. Have a great day.
In the end, the German people had a chance to read the Bible in their own native language. There was also a division between Catholicism and Protestant traditions. Conflicts arose and changes in how religion influenced people's lives. Now, I am going to send it to Grant, where he will be with Pope John.
I'm glad you can join us today. Happy to be here. So, what was the Church's response to the Protestant Reformation?
So, the Church's response to the Protestant Reformation was the Counter-Reformation. And the Counter-Reformation was a movement of the Church to propel the movement of the Protestants to regain the Catholic prestige.
So then, what about the Council of Trent?
In regards to the Ecumenical Council of Trent, it was actually a historic movement that led to the story of many new Christian churches that broke away from the Catholic Church.
Now, I kind of understand the Catholic Revival, but can you explain more about it?
So that was mainly the Roman Catholic efforts directed in the 16th and 17th centuries, both against the Protestant Reformation and toward internal renewal.
So then, what do Catholics lose respect for, and why was that?
Christians just tend to lose respect for those who don't pray to the Lord and those who don't show respect to the Catholic Church. And those who break the rules should be punished. And loving the brotherhood of believers means to love all believers, regardless of color, nationality, opinions, or affiliations. We are to demonstrate to the world we love our brothers and sisters in Christ.
I understand it now. I'm glad you can join us today.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
So, today we found out the background of Protestant Reformation, who Martin Luther is, and what he intended to do, and also what the church thought about Protestant Reformation from the one and only St. John II.
Well, thank you, Grant, for that, and thank you all so much for tuning in for today's news broadcast regarding the Protestant Reformation.
I guess we'll find out where history goes from here. Stay tuned daily at noon for more information with Danny and Grant.
Have a good afternoon, and in case I don't see you guys later, have a good evening.
And good night.
That's it. That's it, Mikey! We're done!
Cut.